Hey everyone. So today I'm going to show you how to create a Zap that will connect up HubSpot and Google Sheets so that when you have a new deal added to HubSpot, it'll create a new row in Google Sheets like this. I've done a few test runs here and basically it's pretty simple. I've already built it and I'll just take you through it. Essentially what we want to do is when a new deal is created in HubSpot like this and it appears in the system like so, it looks like this. We just want to get all the key details and sync them over into the Google Sheet rows like this. So the way we do it is we create a new Zap in Zapier, a new workflow. I like to use the AI for this. So I usually type in a new HubSpot deal to create new Google Sheet row. So we get our new deal. We select our HubSpot account. These are default properties to receive. So these are the ones that will come through. And if you're missing any here, like for example, deal stage isn't included here, then I've selected it here as an additional property to retrieve. And then we can find the records like this. And we get our example record to set up the rest of the Zaps. We then have to find associations because the deal only includes the things that are on the left side here. So it doesn't include information about the associated contact or company. And so I've done separate videos explaining this association before, so I'll link to those. Check those out if you're not sure what I'm talking about here in terms of associations. But basically, we need to look at and find the associations for this deal. And so we go down to this options here. We add in the deal ID and we select the object is a deal. And we want to get two associations relating to this deal and then two associations a contact and company. Click continue. And then when we do the test, it gives us these ID numbers, which we can then use as the following steps. So the next step is get contact. And so for get contact, we want to pull in that deal to contact from the find association step. And then it's going to do a search for this number and find the details about who it is. Where is it? Down here somewhere. And then the company, same thing. The company ID, record ID here. It pulls in these properties for the company. And then we get the example here. So then our last step in the sheet, we select our Google Sheet that we want to update, this deal tracker. We can then select worksheet. Let me delete these, just change that a little bit. And so now we can select what are the properties. We select our worksheet sheet one, and then what are the properties we want to get in here? So we've got deal name, deal ID, company that we got from the company information. I'm just going to use the company name for this value. Now, if you've got more than one contact associated or more than one company associated with a deal, sometimes you might have a deal that has multiple people here. I've done another video that explains looping in Zapier. So you can see how to do a loop and then you can get additional information for additional contacts. In this case, I'm just assuming there's just one contact. So that's what I'm going to put in here. I'm just going to, for the sake of ease, I'm going to put first name, last name, and email. But you probably want to have separate columns for each of these values, depending on how you want to use the data. And then we've got our amount, deal amount, close date, stage. I pulled that before so we can get that info in. And then I'm going to skip these ones for now, and then I'll just add a create date like this, and the last modified date like this. Then we can click continue. We do a test step and we get the data come through like this. You can see here, the only thing that is a little bit messy is that we've got the Unix, I think it's called Unix style dates. And so the date formatting is not the best. Let me see if this will improve it. Okay, that's good. So we can change that in Google Sheet and it's all right. The other option would be to go through a formatting step for date inside Zapier as well, using this format step, but I'll save that for another video. And then that's it. So once you've got it all set up, the final step, publish. And that's all you need to do. And then you should probably do another test run when that's set up so that you can make any changes. And then it's all set. So for the next video, I'm going to go through and I'll share how to handle it. Deals that are updated and then updating the spreadsheet row. A little bit more complicated, so I thought I'd start simple here with this one, and then next time you can check out the next video that's a little bit more detailed. a little bit more complex. So if this is useful for you, you want to see more videos about HubSpot, Zapier, other things relating to sales and digital marketing, please feel free to subscribe and look forward to seeing you in the next video. Cheers.